I've been traveling for days now. I hear word that I'm near my location. I see a tower of oil. I'm so desperate. I shall drink from it. For my thirst. As I approach, I dive in, drinking up some of its oily juices. I flow out. What is this? Could it be? Is it? I run as fast as I can, approaching ever closely. Can it possibly be? Could it have possibly survived? Could the rumors be true? I enter the building. It's the same as I left it. The chests full of trap. My ender eyes and my pigs. My landmarks, my redstone. Everything is how I left it. What about the upstairs, I say? Why, it's the same as well. Not a single difference. What about the downstairs, I say? Why, there's a quarry here, just like the one I left behind. No different. Could it possibly be? Could I have truly returned to the clone factory? Hello guys and welcome back. I hope you like the intro. Basically, what happened was the original clone factory world completely got destroyed. So I basically recreated the house in order to continue the series, because there were so many things I wanted to do, few things that I didn't achieve to do, but I recreated the house block by block. There is literally only small block differences, like this on the floor and this door. It makes it look better, but other than that, I don't think there's any other differences, like anywhere. And also, I have actually perfectly copied the chests over. Like, everything in this chest is exactly what I had in the chest during the last episode. Like, there is literally no difference. You can even go and check in there. Except for, of course, eggs. Like, I ended up, there was two different types of stacks of eggs, and I just sort of merged them together. To create one stack instead, just to save space. However, I accidentally had three buckets, so I'll just freeze away. Actually, no, because that'll be cheating. It's cheating enough that I brought the house back from the deck that it had. So, throwing away the buckets. And it's literally a perfect inch-by-inch copy. Even my current inventory is a bit-by-bit copy, except for I did actually have two stone swords. I just replaced it with one because they were both on pretty low health. The main difference is there's actually no nether portal, and there's no base one anymore. Which means Cheese Hamlet's gone. And also, so are Cheese's friends, other clonage friends. They don't exist anymore. And also, this is a completely new world, so stick that on top. So we got a whole entire new area. And, same house though, it is the exact same house design. Like, I literally didn't have a single difference. Hang on, let me just grab my phone. I literally went back on all my YouTube videos and used it to recreate the house nearly overnight. Like, I had to keep pace with everything I did, the exact amount of glass and how far along it is. Like, compare the two, like the original and this version together, And trust me, it was very, very hard to find a difference. But also, this quarry has gone down a lot because I left it running for quite some time with some fuel. I'm hoping there's no buckets in here because then I'll have to throw them out as well. Because I'm pretty sure I only ever had 9 buckets. Nope, no buckets. I mean, even the same system is just... Oh, whoa, I got mushrooms. I literally just set this to run for a long time at a completely random pace. And it's collected all this stuff for me. And it's quite a lot of stuff actually. It's pretty nice to come home to my new created house to find this. I'll take these just put in there. This arm. Just put in there. That there. And just for the sake of it, this cover and these mushrooms are first. And yeah, this whole entire place is a exact replica, except for, of course, the quarry, because the quarry's been a little bit more independent for a while. But, yeah, so this is a resurrection, as it were. Because I didn't really want to end the series. I'm having a lot of fun. But yeah, basically, the current task we have is creating the final edition of the shell storage, so I can reuse that body, and I'll place the secondary shell storage in the nether, so that I can teleport between the two to the nether fortress. Unfortunately, I've got to literally take the nether fortress, it doesn't quite exist, if you know what I mean. Right, I'm not sure I'm doing this right. I'm hoping, highly hoping that I've got this right. I may be making the wrong one. Shell constructor, yeah, I'm making the wrong one. But don't worry, I still know the recipe. But it's gonna require quite a bit of iron. But it's not like I don't have a lot of iron. There's some more. Also, while looking at this, while replacing some of the things, I noticed there's stuff in this chest that could easily stack inside something in that chest. Just sort of wasting room. There is actually a few items that are actually missing. Oh, there's some iron ore. Only a few items, like stuff that isn't so important. I even copied over the dirt though, so obviously not important. It could have been important. I don't really know how important it was. I wasn't checking. It's not my fault. But yeah, I am going to stick myself some iron ore on so I can make myself an iron block. Yes, indeed. So that I can create my little recipe for shell storage. So I can teleport between hell and earth. Without even the use of a nether portal, but first, of course, I need to create a nether portal, which is a nuisance. Just need one more piece, come on, come on. And bingo. And then block of iron, pressure plate, glass, glass, obsidian, 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 and obsidian, and sink core, shell storage. Lovely jubbly. And then to finish it all off, do I have a redstone torch anywhere? I'll just make one, it's not like it's a hassle or anything. Do I have any sticks anywhere? I'll just make sticks, it's not like it's a hassle or anything. No, no sticks. Okay, dirt, 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 dirt. No, not two sticks. What am I doing? No. Ugh. There we go. Redstone torch. Stop staring at me and just keep running. I'm not gonna create another one just yet. I just want to keep him running though. And also, I may just do this. Change which side the redstone torch is on. And the reason for this is it gives me room to possibly put another treadmill in here. So I can have two pigs running, which will be nice. It'll make creating the next clone a whole lot faster. I'm gonna see how the quarry is getting on. Now I'm gonna go need get obsidian if I can, I have no diamonds, so this is gonna be a struggle. But I have a pick, and there is a pool of lava over there, so I can do the cheap obsidian trick. So my buckets are all here. And I know some of you guys may class this as cheating. Yeah. Just no. I didn't spawn any extra items in. I didn't magically give myself diamonds or anything. You know what? I don't want to. I will see if I actually do have any diamonds, because I don't think I do. But I might as well. I would prefer to look for diamonds rather than to. I've got two diamonds. Not enough. And they were already there in the original chest. So I'm not spawning those diamonds in, but I do need another diamond. And of course, there's none in this cave. Of course, there would be none in that cave. In the bat cave. There's some lapis, though. How low does this cave go? Oh, hello. Don't remember this bit being here. New territory. But yeah, I'm literally continuing from the exact spot that I left off in the previous episode, sort of the exact spot. I mean, there's a few differences, but not many. This is nearly at ground level, so F3. Just gonna take this out, and then let's turn human and let's go diamond hunting, strip mining. It's been a while since I've actually had to mine for myself, but then again, I really need obsidian, and this is the fastest way to do it. Not really, well, probably the easiest way to do it, because it's a bit more of a pain to do it the way I was going to. There's a redstone. Actually see on the map, it's just a straight line. If I come up near any caves, it'll actually show up on the map. Can actually just have a scan of the area. Noises nearby. Am I approaching that area? Whoa, I'm actually moving Oh, faster than I thought I was across this map. Now, if I just dig a few blocks this way, this should be the pool. No pool. Ah, pool. Ugh. It's above me. Okay. Sort of worm our way up into here. Nowhere I can go from here. Never mind. Pool, not important. Let's try what appears to be a cave system this way, because my pig is verging its destruction. Alright, hang on, let me just get rid of this. Also, I forgot to put up the difficulty. Easy, so I've been on peaceful this whole time. Oh dear god. I've passed it. Need to go here and up one block. Okay, nice. Okay, now I just need to sort of stop the water flow. Now there should be lava. Right there! Wow. Okay, let's turn off the lava, shall we? Okay, there we go. Let's turn back into a back while we're in the cave. The bat cave. No, that was horrible. But yeah, I think it's about time to end this resurrectional episode where we've brought back the series. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.